Welcome to the Mr. Rodriguez Show, ladies and gentlemen. I am your host slash art teacher, Mr. Rodriguez. Thanks for tuning in again. Hey, your projects so far are looking pretty sweet. A huge, huge fan of the way you guys are working with your charcoal, and especially since some of you have never done charcoal before, so it's really cool to see you guys going through this. I appreciate your hard work. I like to see your struggles with it because that means you're learning and you're building upon what you already know. It's only the first time of many in middle school, ladies and gentlemen. The next project we have deals with a different medium, painting. As fifth graders, if you remember, you had plenty of moments where you got to deal with painting in my classroom. For example, we spent a lot of what we did spend of the last school year doing painting. How do you essentially capture painting? Where in art history do you pinpoint it? Usually when you think the term art history, the subject art history, your mind goes right to painting. Mona Lisa, again, The Last Supper, American Gothic, A Starry Night. That's kind of where our head goes when you think of painting within art history. Paintings are timeless and deservingly so. Paintings have literally touched every culture of every part of the world. They're immersed in some way, whether you grew up in London, whether you grew up in Russia, whether you grew up in China, whether you grew up in Florida, Mexico. Painting is an essential part of the culture. From caves to walls to even one of my favorite things, comic books, paintings are very prevalent. This particular round, we're going to focus on space, texture, and color. Of course, we're painting, come on. How do you show all that stuff with a painting? I'm gonna show you how. Here are some periods in art that do just that. We're gonna go back to the medieval period, and not just the medieval, the early medieval period, specifically Carolinian art. This is St. Mark from the Gospel Book of Archbishop Ebo of Reims. It's dated between 815 and 830 AD. That means when I say it's dated, that means that's when it was most likely painted, when it came from, you know. This painting was one that particularly caught my eye in college. You know, when you're in art school, you have to learn a lot of art history. You have to learn what you're talking about when you're being an art teacher. And this was one of the many that stuck, really stuck in my brain. You know, what was it that was so captivating to me? I can tell you, it was the line work, the rugged, the jaggedness, the eccentric moving line. And that, you know, intense line makes it almost seem like there's movement going on here. Up until this point, like, that style wasn't really relevant. It wasn't seen much. Everything was a little more precise. For example, some 30 years before this, there was a painting done that was directly an inspiration for this piece. This painting is St. Matthew's from the Gospel Book of Charlemagne, and it depicts St. Matthew in kind of a more smoother manner than St. Mark. And the St. Mark painting really kind of changed that. And when you think of the Ebo Gospels within the art history context, you know exactly, oh, these pieces with these crazy lines and this movement. This was something that brought the Ebo Gospels, you know, to the forefront of their predecessors. The line work gave it movement, it gave it life. You can see the painting has a full background, but the figure is the main character. Our eye goes right to the character at front. It is almost centered, and the background almost showcases it by its use of color. Light green compared to the almost light red really brings that figure to the foreground.
Contrast, ladies and gentlemen. Contrast.
Yeah, I love contrast. And next we move on to an artist that you might be pretty familiar with, Vincent van Gogh. Now, we all know A Starry Night. We've seen it. It's on coffee cups. It's on iPad covers. It's posters, yada yada, big things in movies. You know, my ode to my Boy Meets World fans out there, they'll get this one. We're going to talk about a different one, though. This one has the same overall movement that A Starry Night has, but it's a little more different, which makes it a little more interesting for me. We're going to talk about the Wheat Field and Cypress Trees. This was created in 1889. It's an oil painting on canvas. Van Gogh was a part of a group of artists which we talked about actually when you were in second grade called Post-Impressionism. Those artists followed what was called Impressionism, hence the Post-Impressionism. Impressionism had more of a quaint style. It had, it's more smooth where Post-Impressionism is, I like to think, a little rough around the edges, which is why I prefer that. Just my taste. Impressionism was more smooth. It had that classical feel to it. Soft contrast. Soft contrast was pretty big in Impressionism. Whereas Post-Impressionism, you had more hard contrast and more bold colors. Realism, which you saw in Impressionism, and the classical works, you know, before that, it took a back seat with Post-Impressionism. And I think that it really helped bring Post-Impressionism to be like a worldwide known movement in art. What distinguishes this piece, especially with Van Gogh, is the brushstrokes, which in essence create the line and the movement that you see in the piece. Movement is certainly a big thing here. The moving clouds, the trees, the bushes, the wheat. It feels like you're sitting in the field. It feels like wind's actually like blowing against your face. Like you can feel the wind by looking at this painting. Sorry, I got a little mindful for a minute there.
Ah, Mr. Rodriguez, I see what you did there.
Thank you, Mr. Becker. Van Gogh was a master at capturing movement with his brushstrokes. The way he used different tints and shades of a color next to each other, like in his trees, in the wheat, in the clouds, really, really pushes that bold brushstroke movement that's going on here. What you're gonna do is you're gonna do a part painting that has movement like this. You're gonna choose a figure or a person or a landscape. I'll let you choose one or the other. You are gonna paint it in the style that we kind of just talked about, utilizing line and utilizing movement. If you choose a figure, it must be a figure in motion. If you know, for example, if you're gonna choose Michael Jordan, make sure that you're, you know, Michael Jordan isn't just standing there smiling, being like this. Make sure he's, you know, dribbling the basketball. Make sure he's mid-slam dunk, something that shows movement. If you choose a landscape, the landscape must also be some sort of movement. Trees blowing in the wind, waves crashing onto the shore, you know, and think of all the natural things and weather that we can throw into a landscape as well. You know, thunderstorms, tornadoes, stuff like that. Movement is something we're going to capture. And we're going to do the background completely in paint. And then we're going to use oil pastels to bring our figure to the foreground. You're going to use all your dark colors. Now, I say this with just a little leeway here. You're going to use majority of your dark colors with your paint. Then at the very end, you're going to add the oil pastel to make those, you know, bright colors pop out. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so I have my photo here that I picked that's going to be a perfect example of movement that we're trying to capture here. You can see right here, this is a photo of a Superman flying over the Earth. Now, the photo that I've chosen here to get started is a picture of Superman flying over the Earth. Movement right there. There's so many ways that I can capture movement here. This particular Superman, side note, is Brandon Routh as Superman, which I don't think he got enough respect for as Superman, by the way. Side note, I digress. What I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna first start out on the background. All right, so I'm starting on my background here, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna basically do this entire background with my big brush, my wide brush. You all received the wide brush here. I am going to work on kind of just getting it covered. You might go back to the landscape paintings when we talked about a wash. Now, if you are doing a landscape painting, remember wash is the overall color. If you're doing a figure, you might not need to do it that much because just depending on the photo, you might not need to do a wash the way, you know, I showed you how to do a wash. And I'm gonna do kind of a wash here, but it's gonna be multiple colors. First, it's gonna be black. And then I'm gonna have a good time finding this mixture right here in these colors here. So I'm gonna start with a bright color here because I don't like to wash my brushes when I'm painting because I think it gives it a good overall tone. So I'm gonna start, I have blue, white, and black. And I'm gonna start with blue and white and start with the earth and I'm kinda just paint it right here. I know I don't wash my brush out, but what I'm gonna do is just kind of take this excess paint, just kind of wipe it on the side there. I'm gonna keep a little on there, but I'm gonna go to the black. What I'm gonna do is fill all this yellow space with some black. And you're gonna see that some of the blue that was on my brush is mixing, which is good. And there's my background, pretty easy. So now we're gonna sit here and we're gonna watch the paint dry. I'm kidding, we're not gonna do that. So I'm gonna sit and I'm gonna let this dry. I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna start working on Superman here. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so the paint has somewhat dried here, so I'm gonna start actually adding in the next round here, and what I'm gonna be focusing on is actually Superman here. I have added some colors here that I see, and what I'm gonna do here with my paints is I'm gonna basically do an underpainting, which is the overall shapes and color of Superman. I'm gonna steer away from the bright colors that I see. You know, the white right along the cape right there, the highlights on the side of his face, stuff like that. So I'm gonna take my next size brush, my medium brush. You should have four brushes, one large and a medium. And I'm gonna kinda just plot in the shape of him kinda right here. I'm gonna start with some dark red. How I'm gonna mix my colors, I'll let you use black to make your colors darker to get a shade. I'm gonna stick with that right there. And I'm gonna make a shade of red, just a smidge of black. Now you gotta be careful because you don't want a lot of black to overtake your color because it's kind of hard to go back then. So just a little. And I'm gonna basically make an entire shape that looks like this. And I'm gonna build upon it right here. So, starting with the cape flapping in the back. And the reason why I'm going back here is once I let it dry, I can literally paint over anything there. So, up
there. Where his arm's going down there. See, I'm just kind of trying to find the space. I'm not too worried about the exact, you know, thing yet, because I am building this painting up. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go into fast motion here, and you guys are gonna see how I build this up just by trying to find my overall shapes. I'm not gonna get into details or anything because that's where my oil pastels are gonna come out. Right here, I have my underpainting of Superman. And again, it's just gestural, just trying to find all the shapes because we're not doing details with paint here. So what I'm gonna do is I have to let it dry again because this is wet paint, and now I'm gonna go draw on top of it. So we're gonna let this dry and we'll be back in a bit. It is finally dry, or it's dry-ish. So we can continue on quickly here. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna start addressing these light spots right in here. More just on the figure. I'm not gonna worry about anything else on that background right there. So this is done for me. This is done for me. This needs refinement right here. So I'm gonna start by just looking at the suit, and I'm gonna go in with a blue pastel and a white pastel. And you should be getting your pastels. You should have pastels that I gave you, or you should have some that you will be getting. So don't worry if you don't. All right, I am looking. Move this just a little bit for you. How about over here? All right, so I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna kind of just address where I see a bright blue on Superman. You can see I'm gonna work in lines. I'm not gonna color nice and thick. I'm gonna work in lines because remember, the lines are supposed to help us show movement. So I know it's okay. I'm gonna go right along this arm here because I know this is super bright. So I'm gonna add some white lines in there. And then I'm gonna go back over the blue just with lines, just to kind of, there we go. Well, that suit's really starting to pop now. I like it. Okay, going in for that Superman S right there now. The S is kind of dark here, so I'm gonna let the S kind of blend with that blue. I'm gonna actually take some blue over here too. Blend with the blue right there. I'm gonna color this in. Let it blend with that blue right there because it's dark. And then, not white, yellow. Add in the yellow here. And cool. Going, I'm gonna start dressing this cape right here. And this is where, again, I'm working with the lines, so. We already got the overall shape of most of the stuff. pretty addressed with our paint. Okay. Keep going back and forth, getting some of that drapery in there. Like it. I like it. Go back into some red. Just here and there. Cool. And so far we got the cape and the S of the Superman pretty addressed there. I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna look at his face right there. And for that, I've grabbed a peach, which you've gotten. I'm gonna use a little yellow, brown, and a white. And here we go. All right, I'm gonna go in with the kind of the peach, the tan color. Oh, that was wet right there. That's okay. I'll kind of give it that kind of feel that I want there. I thought that was dry. It's still pretty wet, so I'm gonna let it sit for just a little bit more. So I'm gonna put back on the, you know, waiting for paint to dry music, and we'll be right back. So the paint has dried. We're going to continue on with Superman's face right here. You can see the light side right here. I've been trying to pull out. I'm going to go back in and go with these right here. Remember, I'm not trying to color nice and neat because I want the line work. I want line to show movement here. So I'm going to take that. I'm going to go into fast motion here while I whip through his face and refine his face. And here we go. All right, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to actually take a black pastel to kind of pull out some of these lines right here. And this black pastel will kind of pull up some of the mouth lines and the eyebrows and the eyes and stuff like that. And then I'm going to go back over it. Now, I'm not going to overuse it. I'm not going to rely on this because I still have a lot of darks that are speaking what I want it to do right on there. But I'm just kind of trying to get some of that line pulled out there. Okay, so I pulled it out there. Now I'm gonna go kind of take it back a little bit. So what you're gonna need to do is you're gonna need to think of a figure. It needs to be a human, remember, or it needs to be a landscape. That is going to be the thing that you work from. You're gonna paint the background. Just like an underpainting, you're not gonna go super details like I did. And then your main figure in the foreground is gonna be painted just as an underpainting, getting most of the overall colors and stay, you know, don't get too bright because the brights are pulled out with the oil pastel. Now you can use some black to kind of darken it just a little, but don't overuse it, all right? Good luck. I am excited to see this. I'm excited to see your charcoal drawings. If you work any way, if you work in any fashion that you, if there's any similarity in between the way you worked with the charcoal drawing and the way you do this, these are gonna be outstanding. I'm so excited to see them. And Mr. Rodriguez is getting out of here.